Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Just finished up the Pinnacle Station DLC here, and we've actually got our own apartment or home here. Pretty neat. Because we were able to beat, was it Colonel Ahorn? Ahern! Ahorn. We were able to beat his special scenario from the First Contact War, which he set up a simulation. Where are we supposed to go? I am going to take care of the rest. Right, the Maroon Sea. The rest of the small quests, of which we have two to take care of in the Maroon Sea cluster. And there's one other somewhere else, which I can't remember, which is a, Geth amassing, which is bound to be a huge battle. Doesn't that look suspicious, that star? I can't even get all the way over it. So is that one. Okay, so we got Metano, Vostok, and Caspian. It is a small island in the Caspian Sea. It's sunk. I don't even remember what, which ones we're supposed to go to. MSV Cornucopia. Let's look at these planets first. I like to start with the outermost planet, which is here. Antida. Antida is a standard hydrogen helium gas giant. Its atmosphere is darkened by traces of sodium. It's very salty. It is one of relatively few planets known with an orbital period of more than a millennium. Really? Yeah, crap. 1296.1 Earth years. Funny. Turian Signa recovered. Scans of Antida revealed a group of derelict turrets orbiting the planet. The recon team carefully retrieved one of the turrets and brought it on board. Tally dismantled the weapon and found it was marked with a Carthane outpost insignia. All I'm thinking is the turrets from, Portal 2. Almarcrux. Almarcrux has an atmosphere of methane and ethane. Despite its great distance from Caspian, the energetic young star heats the surface, I guess, to almost temperate levels. Thick ground fogs are common at the Terminator, where water ice frozen during the long dark side night meets the warm air masses from the day side. The crust is mainly composed of copper with deposits of sodium. Again with the salt. Almarcrux's abundant water and relatively mild temperature and gravity have placed it on the short list of terraforming candidate worlds. However, there is significant opposition from eco-ethics groups who assert that Almarcrux's primitive methanotropic bacteria may be a precursor to a full-fledged native ecology. Mm. Farnuri. Farnuri has a trace atmosphere of carbon dioxide and helium. The surface is mainly composed of silica laced with iron oxides, indicating the world had an oxygenated atmosphere at some time in the past. Given the relative youth of the blue star Caspian and the significant gravity well of Farnuri, this must have occurred with astonishing swiftness, perhaps a result of some cataclysmic event. Further research is required. Scans from orbit have detected a large deposit of gold. We're rich! Yahoo! The planet looks gold itself. Final planet, anyway. Klotanka. Klotanka is a large but low-density terrestrial world with an atmosphere of nitrogen and carbon monoxide. Its crust is composed of sulfur and unremarkable silicates. Occasional deposits of heavy metals, usually the result of meteor strikes, dot the surface. High-speed winds powered by the hot blue star Caspian present a constant hazard. Atmospheric entry is hazardous and EVAs are discouraged. Small deposit of iridium. And the MSV Cornucopia. What are you doing here? The Cornucopia is a Kowloon-class modular conveyor of human design. While obviously adrift, the Cornucopia is not broadcasting any distress call. Registry X-Solar Shipping Sol. Okay. Well, let's board it. You know what? Let's mix it up since we found in the previous few episodes that were, like, almost invulnerable. Let's see what happens if we bring Liara and Garrus. Now, we need to level all of them up. I'm gonna go for a few of these special things. Master Overlord with overload with electronics. Stasis. Advanced stasis. I got stuck there. Singularity is pretty neat, huh? Advanced singularity. I'm gonna get stuck on that. And throw. And Garrus has got 50 points. Alright, unlock sniper rifles. Advanced overkill. Increases duration, allows longer bursts, and drains more accuracy. Sniper rifles. Assassination. Next shot will inflict weapon damage plus 50%. Turian agent. Get all those. Very helpful. First aid. Advanced first aid. And electronics. Overload. Assault training. Unlocked. Adrenaline burst. Okay. Equip medium armor. And shield boost. Master overkill. And sabotage. 100 damage and 8 meter radius. Can use just decryption skill on average objects. Well, that's good. Hard objects. Advanced overload. Adrenaline burst. Advanced assassination. Damping, because we didn't take any of that. Alright, so oh yeah. That's gonna be a little better for him. the only thing we have are these two. So I'll give him that. We'll have him use that. Give her this pistol. Nothing available right now. Too bad I got rid of all this crap. I just hate, you know, the gonna save because I made all these changes. Is this? What is this? Kovalov? Okay, good. He's using that by default, which is good because he's trained in that. Anything back here? Nope. So, yeah, interesting to have a different crew. He doesn't say anything? They don't say anything right now. Alright. Oh wow. Cockpit. Well, we have no idea what's going on in here, right? Journal? System. Okay. These are the two systems we actually didn't go to, so we have really no reason to be here. Which is interesting because we are here. I'm not trusting.
I smell trouble!
I'm like, who said that? I'm not used to Garrus being here.
Guess we don't have to worry about looking for survivors.
Guess not.
Area secured.
Really? No, it isn't. That is not secure. Yeah, I am so disappointed in you. Well, you blew up the containment unit.
Perimeter clear.
Sure about that? I'm not sure about that. I don't think you should be sure about that. Oh, can't get through there. Can't squeeze through there, okay. It's a veritable maze of crates and crap. Come out, come out! No? Oh, he scared me. That one's still alive. Come on out.
Targets down.
Uh-huh. For now. I hate those things. They scare me. I know there's more.
Over there.
Hit the containment unit. There's another one. No likey. I no likey. Oh. Oh my. Can we do lift? Where's lift? You need lift. Oh. There's one right. Oh, there was. Make such a mess. to be so gooey all the time. Oh, we're near the cockpit, sorta. I don't like when they come from all sides. It's not fun. Warp. I don't know why I gave him a warning shot over his head just then. Hey, the door. I don't believe you. Sorry. Okay, maybe it is secure. No special crates or anything? Alright. Functioning object. Combat Exoskeleton 8. You don't talk? Speak. Speak. You just kinda don't talk. Maybe just not on this. Maybe if we go down to a planet they will. Yeah, I got these two things. The plaintiff haze. Oh, yeah. We don't have anything for Garrus. She can wear human armor. Well, look at that. Predator 7 is a much better. They're identical. What are the odds? So she's got milk and face. I mean, we can give her this combat exoskeleton. And Garrus. We can give him medical interface 7, I believe. Another malfunctioning object. Oh, another medical interface. Nice. Or was it? It was an exoskeleton, wasn't it? I'm just thinking medical interface. I don't like that. It's like a skull and crossbones. Medical exoskeleton. Let's give that to Liara. .7 health regeneration. There we go. Keep her alive better. Oh god. You can barely touch these things at all. Pistol, assault rifle, and sniper rifle. Okay. Not any better. .63. It's a lot better than what he has. Prior rounds on that. And assault rifle. It's not as good as what he has. And sniper rifle. Oh yeah, much better. Unfortunately, we don't have anything to give him. Except for, I guess, shredder rounds. proton. Yeah, proton. Oh, none of them are really good against these things. What are you doing running all over the place for? Final door. The door's already open. Oh wait, this is where we came from. This is the pilot cockpit thing. Navigation computer.
According to the log files, the ship was out near the Perseus Vale. Looks like they found some kind of alien artifact. They brought it on board and then... This doesn't make any sense. They plotted a course straight into the Perseus Vale, like they wanted the Geth to find them.
You think so? They were brainwashed?
That artifact must have done something to them. Why else would someone fly into Geth space?
The entries don't make a lot of sense after that. It's like the captain's mind was falling apart. Doesn't say anything about how the ship got back into human territory.
The Geth transformed them into husks, and left the vessel where they knew it would be found. A warning to other organics not to enter the Vale.
Mm-hmm. Journal, I guess. Derelict freighter. Well, we just completed the quest of derelict freighter.
According to the log files, the ship was out near... They brought it on board and then... This doesn't make any sense. They plotted a course straight into the...
What else did the log say?
The entries don't make a lot of sense after that. It's like the captain's mind was falling apart. Doesn't say anything about how the ship got back into human territory.
The Geth transformed them into husks and left the vessel where they knew it would be found. A warning to other organics not to enter the Vale.
Okie doke. Well, this is a pretty small episode. It would be if I left off here. Now we gotta navigate our way back, do all this crap. Just to get back. Hopefully nothing else hiding out here. So yeah, I'll head to the other system. And we'll continue on. Yeah, through here. Alright, so, done. Two more systems to go to, I think. Caspian. Okay. Vostok. I forget which thing we had to do here. Potato? The potato planet? It's a rather small hydrogen helium gas giant. Potato's atmosphere contains large quantities of chlorine. Doesn't look like much of a potato. Matrix writings recovered. Scans revealed a strange unmanned vessel in orbit around a planet. Tally brought it on board and determined it was a sorry maid, but very old. She discovered several ancient artifacts inside the vessel, including one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. She must have been thrilled about that. Alco? The geological properties of alkyl have been scanned from orbit, but little else is known about it. A fairly typical mixed outer system terrestrial of rock and ice, alkyl has a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. Its crust is composed of silicates and water ice with deposits of aluminum. Unregistered starship traffic has been recorded in the vicinity of this planet. Travel is not advised. I wonder what's going on here. Oh, there's that Nordacrux we have to go to. Okay. Let's check out Clomorthu first. Clomorthu has a reducing atmosphere of methane and nitrogen. The surface is hot and mainly composed of sodium with deposits of uranium. In terms of size and orbit, Clomorthu is a virtual twin of Earth, but utterly lacks life. You're right. Same year. I don't know about radius. Days are 18.8 hours long. Atmospheric pressure and gravity are almost the same. And Nordacrux.
Looks like we've got an active distress beacon on the planet below, Commander. No message, just a locator signal.
Mm-hmm. Nordacrux is a verdant world with abundant water, temperate climate, a thick nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere, and a rich ecosystem. It would seem to be perfect for life. The relatively high percentage of oxygen makes humans feel energized and alive, though it has also allowed insect analogs to grow to frightful sizes. Oh boy, we're gonna be fighting bugs. Unfortunately, Nordacrux is a case of almost not quite. Thunderstorms are as common as on Earth, but in Nordacrux's thicker, oxygen-rich atmosphere, they are deafening and spark constant wildfires. More damning, however, are the large and ubiquitous tufts of pollen that float on the high-pressure air. In humans and other oxygen-breathing species, they cause severe or lethal allergic reactions. Sounds great. Let's land. Let's take Liara and Garrus again. How pretty. Look at those clouds. So pretty, look at all that. Nice. I see the pollen! Anyway. Investigate the facilities on the planet Nordacrux in the Vostok system of the Maroon Sea cluster for clues. About exogeny facility, right. Okay, we got a science facility, debris, and an anomaly. We'll go right for the anomaly. Well, there's something dangerous over there. A red thingy. Oh, a couple red thingies. Where is it? Oh, hello. Thorian creepers. Creepers, G-Weepers. Don't get back up. More creeper? That way? What is this? Do I want to get out with this creeper thing that's, like, kind of close? Is it over that way? I don't think we can do anything with this, though. There's no option. A fallen probe or something? Should go destroy the other creeper? Probably over this hill. Hello, Monsieur Creepers. Blew you up.
Enemy contact.
Oh, it's on us. Get up. We're back up.
I think we're done here.
I think we're done here. Oh, we can go in there. Oh, wrong button.
Got it.
That's weird having them with us. Interesting that this stuff doesn't show up on the map. Hard decryption. Yeah, I'm not gonna make this one. Nope. Shotgun, assault rifle, and medium armor. Not an improvement. I'm not even sure if she can use a shotgun. More likely that Garrus can, so let's give it to him. Oh, and was it assault? Was it an assault rifle? I don't even remember. Storm one. Yeah. That's probably what he was holding. I don't know. Was it sniper? No. Let's just get rid of this. Oh yeah, it must have been one of these. Yeah, Lancer 9. Get rid of that really old one that he had. Okay, and medium armor. Yeah. Not an improvement. Yeah, we got really good armor last time. Easy decryption. Pistol, assault rifle, biotic amp. Pistol, assault rifle. There you go. Still nothing for him. Okay. Get rid of these. Shotgun and sniper rifle. Sniper. Was that an improvement for him? Oh yeah. Okay, that's that. Okay. Stuff that wasn't on the map. Oh, this is where the anomaly is. Alright. Oh wait, we're not we're not there. I thought we were there, we're here. Okay, never mind. Don't mind me. Going insane. Oh, there's something over here. Oh, I'm crashing into the damn thing. There's something this way. Let's go see. You can do it! You can do it! Do it now! Whoops! Aye! Okay, let's go for it. Whee! And the craft is not damaged. And we're... This thing is where? We're right on top of the freaking thing. It's gonna be in here. Oh, it's a gold deposit. Nice. Oh god, level terrain. Is that better? I hit the wrong key again. Bloop.
On my way.
Plop. Give us the gold. Large deposit of gold. I thought something else was running towards us. I was like, crap. I don't want to deal with those things. Oh no. Wait. Hold up. Oh, we're stuck.